السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to my daily Arabic vocabularies. I am مدرس سليمان علي. Happy listening. We are going to learn from this lesson how to change the Arabic verb لا ينتهي to suit some certain pronouns in Arabic. نهيٌ prohibition. نهيٌ prohibition. We are going to learn how to instruct others not to do something in Arabic using different forms of verbs. The question is, how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit the pronouns below? لا ينتهي simply means he should not finish, and he in Arabic is huwa, being the opposite of here, she. So how do we now change the verb لا ينتهي to suit the following pronouns? واحد, number one, Anna, I. So how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit Anna? All you need to do is to detach ياون and attach ألفون. So the verb لا ينتهي will now become لا أنتهي, which means I shouldn't finish. اثنان, number two, نحن, we. So how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit نحن? All you need to do is to detach ياون and attach نونون. So the verb لا ينتهي will now become لا ننتهي, which means we should not finish. ثلاثة, number three, أنت, you, representing a single male person. So how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit أنت? All you need to do is to detach ياون and attach تاون. So the verb لا ينتهي will now become لا تنتهي, which means don't finish, commanding a single male person. أربعة, number four, أنتي, you, representing a single female person. So how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit أنتي? All you need to do is to detach ياون and attach تاون. Not only that, then you attach ياون to the last letter. Remember, once ياون is attached, the letter before it must take كسرة, as we know that ياون is the mother of كسرة in Arabic. So the verb لا ينتهي will now become لا تنتهي, which means don't finish. You can only use this to command a single female person not to finish. خمسة, number five, here, she. So how do we change the verb لا ينتهي to suit here? All you need to do is to detach ياون and attach تاون. So the verb لا ينتهي will now become لا تنتهي, which means she should not finish. Remember, we use ياون to talk about a single male person and تاون to talk about a single female person. Talking about them does not mean talking to them directly. لعلك فهمت؟ I hope you understand. MashaAllah. Udurus, learn. Walahis, and observe at the same time. Udurus, study. Walahis, and observe at the same time. Mufradun, singular. Muthanna, dual. Jamu, plural. Mufrad, singular. This is a word in Arabic that means only one. Muthanna, dual. This is a word in Arabic that means only two. Jamu, plural. This is a word in Arabic that means more than two, from fair upward. Plurality in Arabic starts from fair upward, unlike English, where it starts from two upward. Then we talk about mudhakkar. Mudhakkarun, masculine. This is a word in Arabic that means that it represents a male person or a male object. Just like the verb, la tantahi, can only be used to command a single male person not to finish. If there are two in number, all you need to do is to attach ألفون to the last letter. Remember, once ألفون is attached, the letter before it must take فتحة, as we know that ألفون is the mother of فتحة in Arabic. So the verb لا تنتهي will now become لا تنتهي, which means you should not finish, commanding two male persons not to finish. So if there are more than two, all you need to do is to attach wawun to the last letter. Remember, once wawun is attached, the letter before it must take dhamma, as we know that wawun is the mother of dhamma in Arabic. So the verb la tantahi will now become la tantahu, which means you should not finish, commanding a group of male persons not to finish. So you may ask me, the allophone written there after the wawun, so what is it doing there? The allophone is only telling you that the wawun written before me is not part of the verb. Rather, it is an extra letter. La'alaka fahimt? I hope you understand. Masha Allah. Then we talk about mu'annath. Mu'annathun feminine. This is a word in Arabic that represents a female person or a female object. Just like the verb la tantahi can only be used to command a single female person, not to finish. So if they are two in number, use the same form of the verb la tantahiya. So if they are more than two, you go and replace ya'un in la tantahi with nunun karim fataha. Then you give sukun to the letter before it. So the verb la tantahi will now become la tantahina. La tantahina, which means you should not finish, commanding a group of female persons. La'alaka fahimt? I hope you understand. Masha Allah. Al-istimal, now the usage. Wahid number one. La yantahi darsu sa'at al-khamisa masa'an. La yantahi darsu sa'at al-khamisa masa'an. La yantahi dars. The lesson should not finish. As-sa'at al-khamisa at 5 o'clock, masa'an, in the evening. Ithnan, number two. La tantahi Zainab min at-tadris ba'da as-salat. La tantahi Zainab min at-tadris ba'da as-salat. La tantahi Zainab. Zainab should not finish min at-tadris, from teaching, ba'da as-salat, after the prayer. Thalatha, number three. La tantahi min kalamik ya ahi. La tantahi min kalamik ya ahi. La tantahi, you should not end your talk, ya ahi, my brother. La tantahi min kalamik, you should not end your talk, ya ahi, my brother. Arba'a, number four. La tantahi min kiraatiki ya ukti. La tantahi min kiraatiki ya ukti. La tantahi min kiraatiki, you should not end your recitation, ya ukti, my sister. La tantahi min kiraatik, you should not end your recitation, ya ukti, my sister. Hamsa, number five. La tantahiya min al-amal gadan. La tantahiya min al-amal gadan. La tantahiya min al-amal. You should not finish from the work, gadan, by tomorrow. Talking to Hashim and Khalid. La tantahiya min al-amal. You should not finish from the work, gadan, by tomorrow. La'alaka fahimt? I hope you understand. Masha Allah. Sita, number six. La tantahu min al-ijtima' al-an ya ikhwa. La tantahu min al-ijtima' al-an ya ikhwa. La tantahu min al-ijtima'. You should not finish from the meeting. Al-an, now. Ya ikhwa, brothers. La tantahu min al-ijtima' al-an. You should not finish from the meeting. Al-an, now. Ya ikhwa, brothers. La tantahu min al-ijtima' al-an. You should not finish from the meeting now, ya ikhwa, brothers. Sab'a, number seven. La tantahina min al-imtihan gadan, ya ahawat. La tantahina min al-imtihan gadan, ya ahawat. La tantahina min al-imtihan. You should not finish from examination, gadan, by tomorrow, ya ahawat, sisters. Commanding a group of female persons not to finish. Thamania, number eight. لا أنتهي من الدراسة هذه السنة. لا أنتهي من الدراسة هذه السنة. لا أنتهي من الدراسة. I shouldn't finish from studies هذه السنة by this year. لا أنتهي من الدراسة. I shouldn't finish from studies هذه السنة this year. تسعة, number nine. لا ننتهي من هذا الموضوع اليوم. لا ننتهي من هذا الموضوع اليوم. لا ننتهي. We should not finish من هذا الموضوع اليوم, from this topic, اليوم, today. لا ننتهي. We should not finish من هذا الموضوع, from this topic, اليوم, today. لعلك فهمت. I hope you understand. ما شاء الله. Now the comparison between أمر commandment and نهي prohibition. واحد, number one. هو, he. لينتهي, he should finish. لا ينتهي, he should not finish. إثنان, number two. هي, she. لتنتهي, she should finish. لا تنتهي, she should not finish. ثلاثة, number three. أنا, I. لأنتهي. I should finish. لا أنتهي. I shouldn't finish. أربعة number four. نحن. We. لننتهي. We should finish. لا ننتهي. We should not finish. خمسة number five. أنت. You. Representing a single male person. انتهي. Finish. لا تنتهي. Don't finish. ستة number six. أنت. You. Representing a single female person. انتهي. You should finish. لا تنتهي. You should not finish. سبعة. Number seven. أنتم all of you. Referring to a group of male persons. انتهوا. You should all finish. لا تنتهوا. You should not finish. ثمانية. Number eight. أنتن all of you. أنتن all of you. Referring to a group of female persons. انتهينا. انتهينا. You should all finish. لا تنتهينا. You should not finish. لعلك فهمت؟ I hope you understand. ما شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Do not forget to click the link below to download any of my books. Write it at the comment section. مع السلامة وإلى اللقاء آخر.